Sorry, oh Lord, I'm sorry. I know this is coming upon me because of my evil doing, because of my unfaithfulness and inconsistency. Because you see everything I've done in the dark, and that's why this pressure and pain is coming upon my life. Repent so that you'll not perish with the people, that even after suffering, then the transgressors still go on until they come to the full. Jeremiah chapter 5, I'm reading from verses 3 and 4. Jeremiah chapter 5, I'm reading from verse 3. Oh Lord, and not mine eyes upon the truth that was tricking them, but they have not grieved. That was tricking them. You have punished them. You have chastised them. You have disciplined them. And yet, it says, they have not grieved. Thou hast consumed them, but they refuse to receive correction. They have made their faces harder than a rock. They have refused to return. Therefore, I say, surely these are poor, they are foolish, for they know not the way of the Lord, nor the judgment of their God. The Lord is calling us to reasoning. He's saying, reason, think about it, and know that this is coming upon you because of your sin. And then turn to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm sorry. Don't just say, okay, whatever happens, I'll be, you know, if you're not careful, if you continue like that and become adamant and rigid in sin, hellfire will be the final place of abode for the one that has been upon reproved and yet will not take correction. And Stephen says, nay, we're looking at me at Revelation chapter 16. Revelation chapter 16, I'm reading from verse 9. Revelation chapter 16, verse 9. And men were scorched with great heat, and they blasphemed the name of God, which has power over these plagues, and they repented not to give him glory. Punishment came, suffering came, chastisement came. And it says, they were scorched with great heat, and yet in the midst of the suffering, they were blaspheming God. In verse 10, it says, and the fifth angel poured out his beer upon the siege of the beast, and his kingdom was full of darkness, and they gnawed their tongues for pain, and blasphemed the God of heaven because of their pains and their sores, and repented not of their deeds. All that suffering did not bring them to repentance, but they just continued in their evil. I pray for you, for me, for us, it will be different in Jesus' name. We come to point number 3 now, which is the deceptive policy of the Antichrist. The deceptive policy of the Antichrist. When that Antichrist comes eventually, he'll use deception. He'll use a deceit. He'll use a craft. We're looking at Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. And through his policy also shall he cause craft, deception to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall he destroy many. Have you ever heard something like that before? By peace shall he destroy many. When the Antichrist comes, it's not going to be. Sometimes he'll hide his fierceness, he'll hide his tyranny, he'll hide his wickedness, and then he looks smooth on the outside and pleasant on the outside and peaceful on the outside, so as to catch the people. He'll talk nice, he'll talk kind, and then when he talks like that, people will say, this is the kind of leader we need. This one cannot hurt anybody. He'll just be very pleasant to everybody, but that's his deception. He shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall he destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. Eventually, he'll be destroyed. I said he'll be destroyed. But you know, here is where we need you. Where we need to really have real, real wisdom. Real wisdom. In our lives, even though the Antichrist has not really come now, but he's still coming. But already we have read in the Bible that the spirit of the Antichrist is already in the world. You know, sometimes maybe you're a lady, and you have not married yet, and somebody comes with the spirit of the Antichrist, the spirit of deception, and they talk smooth, and they talk kind, and they look very nice, and they look very caring, and then they're not even born again, but they may be in church, and they're hiding somewhere in the church there, and they say, yes, I'm brother so-and-so, and then the Lord is sending me to you, would you, can I have your hand in my, this is just the will of God, I'm not forcing anything, this is just the will of God. And the way the fellow talks, so smooth, and so nice, and so pleasant, and so peaceful, you say, what else am I looking for? Why do I need to pray? Why do I have to pray for donkey years? Pray years, 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 when this nice person is asking for my hand. And eventually you get to, when you get to him, then you see the Antichrist in his true color. The way the Antichrist behaves, and the way the Antichrist lives, and the way the Antichrist deceives people, and the way some men, even some women too, they look nice, and they look gentle, and they look so inviting, and just until they get their will. That's why the Lord is saying, be a man of understanding, and be a woman of understanding, so that the craft and the deception and the flattery of the Antichrist will not catch you. You will escape his hand in Jesus' name. I'm going to read it to you again, chapter 8 of Daniel. Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. And through his policy, shall he cause craft to prosper in his hand. Craft, deception. You know, sometimes you want to do business and you have collected all this, your capital, and then you're looking for a partner in business, and this fellow comes and he says, well, I have this qualification. The way he talks is so convincing. And then you bring all your money, and then he says, we're going to, well, when the profit comes, we'll do it like this, we'll do it like this. Do we need to write any paper of agreement and sign it and allow a lawyer to help us or draft any? Why are we, are we not children of God? The way I talk to you, can I cheat you? If you want, we can even, you can open the bank account and open it in your name. Then you are convinced that this man, so gentle, cannot hurt anybody. And then you put all your capital there. The spirit of the Antichrist has deceived you. And eventually everything is gone. That's why the Lord is saying, have the Holy Ghost within you that will make you to discern, that will make you to be able to see, this is not for real. This is just deception. And I pray that the Lord will show you that, and then you'll take heed in your life in Jesus' name. Verse 25, and through his policy also, he shall cut craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes. He'll even be opposing the Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the prince of princes, our Savior and Lord. But then the Bible says, but it shall be broken, it shall be destroyed, that without hands, in Jesus' name. We're looking at chapter 11, verse 21. Chapter 11 of Daniel, verse 21. 11, 21. It says, and in his estate shall he stand up, shall stand up a vile person, to whom they shall not give honor of the kingdom, but he shall come in peaceably. They will not give him any honor. They will not give him the control of the kingdom, but he'll come in peaceably. You will think, this one will not hurt anybody. This one cannot do evil. This one, I can, if I were not a Christian, I can cheat this one. This one is dull, this one is dense, this one is kind of, you know, you can override this person. That's what you think. When he comes out in his true color, you are gone. I pray God will deliver you. I say God will deliver you. It says, he come in peaceably and obtain the kingdom by flatteries. He'll flatter you to death. And then it's when you are dead, you will know that something has really happened. Look at verse 23. And after the league made with him, he shall walk deceitfully. The Antichrist, when he comes, he'll walk deceitfully. For he shall come up and shall become strong with a small people. Verse 24. He shall enter peaceably even upon the fat places of the province. He shall do that which his fathers have not done. that what other people have not been able to do, the pressure, the oppression, the persecution, the pain that you will cause people, he'll just come in peacefully, and then he'll be able to do his evil, nor his father's fathers. He shall scatter among them the prey and spoil and riches. Yea, he shall forecast his devices against the strongholds, even for a time. Verse 27, and both these kings' hearts shall be to do mischief. They shall speak lies at one table. They'll sit on the same table like this, and you see the face of, you know, that man, the Antichrist, and everything will look innocent, and everything will look peaceful, everything will look like, you know, whatever you want, I'm just here to help you, I'm just here to take care of you, I'm just here to defend your rights and defend whatever belongs to you. That's what they say. And it says, they shall speak lies at one table. In that verse 27, but it shall not prosper, for yet the end shall be at the time appointed. Look at chapter 11, verse 32, the first part of verse 32. But, and such as do wickedly against the covenant shall be corrupt by what? By flatteries, by flatteries. When you find people that just flatter you and flatter you and flatter, even where you know that maybe you know that you are weak in this area, you are weak in this area, they never talk about that. They just flatter you and flatter you and flatter you. So something is going wrong. They want to kill and destroy you. That's why the flattery is there. And it says the people that do wickedly, it shall corrupt them by flatteries. That's the method and that's the policy of the Antichrist. And the people that have that nature and that spirit of the Antichrist, that's how they will behave. Look at Proverbs chapter 26, I'm reading from verse 25. Proverbs 26, verse 25. When he speaketh fear, when he speaketh peaceably, when he speaketh nice, believe him not. For there are seven abominations in his heart. Seven abominations in his heart. And yet, he's speaking peacefully, speaking flattery. That's the Antichrist. I pray God will deliver us in Jesus' name. Let us come back to Daniel chapter 8. In Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. Will the Antichrist prosper forever? No, he'll be destroyed. I said he'll be destroyed. Let's look at Daniel chapter 8. Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. And through his policy also, shall he cause Crash to prosper in his hand. And he shall magnify himself in his heart. By peace shall he destroy many. And he shall also stand up against the prince of princes. Tell me the rest of that verse. But he shall be broken, he shall be destroyed without hands. Daniel chapter 11 verse 45. Daniel 11 verse 45. And he shall plant the tabernacles of his palace between the seas and the glorious holy mountain. Yet he shall come to his edge. He shall come to his end, and none shall help him. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. I'm reading there from verse 7 and verse 8. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 from verse 7, verse 8. For the mystery of iniquity does already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth. That Antichrist, the Lord will consume him with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Then all this that we're studying is for the latter days, for the end of time, when that Antichrist will show up. But even now, in 1 John chapter 2, the Lord is calling us to wisdom. And that's why the Lord is revealing all these things unto us. He says, yes, the abomination spoken of by Daniel, it is coming, and it will be for the time of the end. But now we need to take heed to ourselves, because even that spirit of the Antichrist is already in the world. We're told in 1 John chapter 2 verse 18. Chapter 2 verse 18. Little children, it is the last time. Little children, it is the last time. And as ye have heard that the Antichrist shall come, even now at their what? Many Antichrists. Whereby we know it is the last time. If there are many antichrists, then number one, you check up in your own heart. Do I have the traits of the antichrist? Do I have the spirit of the antichrist? Do I operate like the antichrist? Am I deceptive? Do I want to destroy people and yet I flatter them? I come peaceably and I had the wickedness in my heart and appear as if nothing is happening, as if I'm a friend when I'm an enemy? Do I act like that? Ask yourself. If the Bible says now are there many antichrists, you also need to check up the people that flock around you, the people that approach you, the people that come to touch your life and they say, can we do this together? Can we get married? Can we do this? Can we do that? Can we join business together? Are there some antichrists that are approaching you and they talk nice and they talk well and yet in their heart is to destroy you? That's why you need to be vigilant and to say, Lord, I don't want to get into the hand of any antichrist. I don't want the spirit of the age and the spirit of the antichrist to have anything to do with me. Oh Lord, deliver me, and the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name. We're looking at 1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter 4, I'm reading verse 3. Every spirit that confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. This is that spirit of antichrist whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. This is that spirit of antichrist whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. I pray that God will make you to watch and to pray so that that day will not come upon you unprepared, unawares. Let's rise up and talk to the Lord in prayer. The Lord has revealed quite a lot to us today as we have studied about this prophecy of Daniel. Pray that the Lord, who has taught us and led us into the truth, will grant you understanding. And that your heart will not reject or resist the word of God, but your heart will become very serious with the word of God. Be like Daniel, be like Daniel. He meditated on the word. He meditated on the word. And it was the meditation of the word that made God to send the angel to him to grant him understanding. As you rise up and as you pray, you are telling the Lord, oh Lord, I want to have understanding. I want to have understanding. I want to have understanding. It's those who don't have understanding that will be destroyed, that will perish. It's those who do not have understanding that will just destroy themselves because they don't have understanding. Tell the Lord, help me to meditate on the word, to count the word serious. Not just to come as the people come and to listen as the people listen and not to count it very serious, because the last days are upon us already. The last days are upon us already. And the spirit of the antichrist is already at work. Pray that the Lord will not allow you to be caught, to be captured by the spirit of the antichrist. A proper understanding will lead you to repentance. A proper understanding will lead you to salvation. A proper understanding will lead you to restoration. A proper understanding of the word of God will lead you to examine yourself. Say, oh Lord, I'm praying that that evil day will not come upon me unawares, unprepared. Tell the Lord, examine your life, examine your life. Where do you stand? What effect, what impact is this study having upon your heart? Are you like Daniel, that this word makes you thoughtful? This word makes you to meditate. This word makes you to apply to the mercy of God, saying, oh Lord, have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. And when Daniel sought for the interpretation, God sent an angel. And we know it's the Holy Ghost that gives us understanding, enlightenment, illumination, knowledge today. No more angels, but the Holy Ghost. But if we're grieving the Holy Ghost by bitterness, by wrath, by anger, by wickedness, by cruelty, by lying, by unkind words, if we do not allow the Holy Ghost to be a resident within us, How will he give us the enlightenment, the illumination, the understanding, the application, the interpretation of the word? Be sure you are saved. Be sure you are born again. Be sure your sins are all forgiven. Be sure you are living a victorious life, victory over sin. Be sure you are living in holiness and righteousness every moment of the day, all the days of your life. Sanctification, holiness, purity of heart. The Holy Spirit finds it easy to operate, easy to enlighten, easy to illuminate. Whereas holiness and purity is the Holy Spirit. It will not stay, it will not dwell in an unclean heart, unclean environment, impure environment. The Holy Spirit lives, abides, resides in a holy heart, sanctified heart, pure heart. His resident teacher, his resident comforter, his resident guide, is the one that sheds light on the world for you, gives you understanding. What a wonderful experience to be saved. What a wonderful experience to be saved.